Welcome to Get Going, the Golang introduction course from Developer Student Clubs EIT. I am Angad Sharma and I'm going to walk you through what we are going to learn in this course. So we are going to get started with an introduction where we will be learning how to install Go into our system, and then we will be learning about the file structure of Go and how everything is laid out in your Go directories. Then we will make a simple Hello World program. In section 2, we'll be learning about different data types, declarations, initializations, string arrays, pointers, structs. Then we'll be moving on to some more advanced data types like interfaces, and finally control structures like if, else, switch case, select, blocks. In section 3, we're going to be moving on to some more advanced topics like concurrency and parallelism, where we'll be talking about Go routines and channels, buffered channels, unbuffered channels. Then we'll be making a simple ping pong game using Go routines. Then after that, we'll be looking at select block and how select block can be used to really see what channels we're getting our information on. And in section 4, we're going to be learning about API development and server-side programming using Golang, where we'll be learning about the model view controller architecture, and then we'll be making a simple server in Golang. After that, we will be following a list of videos where we will be making a to-do list API with creation, insertion, deletion, or CRUD operations. Create, read, update, and delete. In section 5, we will be hosting our pre-made API into Heroku. So we will be using Heroku as a hosting service. So I'm going to be talking about vendoring, code pushing, cloud repositories, and how you can access your API not only from your machine, but from any machine. So finally, after all of this, our course is going to be finished. So this course is not a completely in-depth tutorial of Golang. Rather, it is to give you a brief introduction to the Go programming language. So after you are done with this course, you can simply move on to some more advanced topics, and you can easily get started with the project after this course. So deliverables include: after this course, you'll be able to make any project you want using Golang, and you won't be scared. And if you want some learning resources also, I'm going to be providing links in the resource section. So if you want documentation or if you want an online compiler, you can always go to golang.org, where you can run code right from the browser. And if you want a more step-by-step approach towards learning Go, you can also go to Go by Example, where it's going to give you small snippets, which you can try it out on your own console. So let's get started. And I'll be pushing all of my code in a repository, loadbalancer/getgoing. I'll be providing the link in the description. And be sure you check it out. All of the course material is going to be here, and it's going to be segregated along with sections. So I'm also going to be posting some more references as we go along. Thank you guys, and stay tuned.